Baby, you understand me now. If sometimes you see that I'm mad, don't you know no one alive can always be an angel? When everything goes wrong, you see some bad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh, Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Hey, guys, it's Humble Spirit. Today, I just want to talk a little bit about the marches and the protests and just all those things that everybody participates in. You know, it feels like they have something new to march about literally every month. Like, literally. You know, now they have kids marching about gun violence, I think it is. I don't really keep up with them, honestly, guys, because it's all just like a bunch of mess. But I think it's gun violence that the kids are now marching about. You know, which is a good move, honestly, for the elite. Because if the kids are scared, you know, and the kids are standing up for everyone, you know, about gun violence, then we must do something, right? Hence, take your guns. But, you know, these marches basically are propaganda and agenda, and they are very, very pointless. You know, they definitely don't want the younger generation waking up to this corrupt world and this mass awakening that's kind of happening right now. They don't want the kids to be awakened, basically. You know, how I feel about it, which is why I'm even making this podcast right now, is, you know, why are we not protesting and marching about all the things, you know, that in a sense we can change? Or why aren't we protesting about good? Or I don't know, you know, why are we protesting and marching about all the things that we cannot change and that honestly do not matter? Like, that don't matter at all. You know, why are we not out here with signs and, you know, and filled with as much joy and willingness, you know, telling everyone our Lord is returning? Why is that not something that we're out there saying or holding signs for or whatever? If anybody should be saying anything like that, though, should be these so-called Hebrew Israelite camps. No bashing. But, I mean, instead of trying to beat in everyone's head what nationality you are when you guys are standing on the street, you know, y'all should be talking about what matters, since you guys are the ones on the streets trying to reach people, correct? So, you know, if anything, I mean, I would think that the Hebrew Israelite camps would be the ones out there, in a sense, in response to all these marches and in response to all these protests and movements, you know, like I said, telling everyone, you know, our Lord is returning and being filled with joy and et cetera, as everybody is out there, in a sense. They're very happy to be out there marching. So, you know, we all should be out here saying that our true Lord is coming back. That would be amazing if everybody would do that. You know, every time something of prophecy happens, you know, we're out there telling that our Lord is near, telling that our Lord is returning. You know, how amazing would that be, guys, if we really were out here, you know, like I said, signs or whatever, saying that our Lord is returning. Like I said on a previous podcast, I mean, the only ones I've ever seen like that is homeless people, houseless people. So, I mean, we all should be out here as well, just like them, and having signs and saying our Lord's returning, or, you know, whatever's going on is because of whatever. And, you know, like, we're truly on a level out there, not just out there for no reason. You know, I feel like everybody wants to be a part of something, but it's never anything truly of our Lord. Instead, everybody joins and is a part of everything that is government produced, Satan produced. Now, if we think about the word government for a second, we pause and we think about government. Govern means to conduct the affairs of people, to preside over, to rule, to reign over, control, lead, etc. Okay? So, I mean, for starters, that'd be why everyone is joining these marches and movements and protests and whatever, because the government is telling them to. Leading the people whichever way they want them to go, leading them in whatever agendas that they want them to participate in, whatever agendas they need energy in, because they take our energy. That's why you have to be careful what you're participating in, because they will take your energy from it. You can give energy to the devil through that. You can give energy to these demons. You can give energy to this beast system, period. But, you know, if you're putting energy into all this, because, like I said, they're telling you to do it because the government, that's what they are there for. You know, they're telling you to do all this because we have no minds anymore. We have no minds now. You know, we gave up our minds when we stopped reading the Holy Bible and stopped listening to our Heavenly Father. That's whenever we, our minds, you know, became non-existent. You know, which is why my mind is so twisted up. Like, we already have someone to lead us, guide us, reign over us, and rule us. I think you guys know who I'm talking about. Our Lord. I mean, you know, he came down here and basically proved he is our Lord. So therefore, you shouldn't be answering, you shouldn't be doing whatever another person is telling you to do or entity is telling you to do. Because we already have someone that proved that he's our Lord and he's over all, the Lord of all. You know, so this all brings me back to why are we marching for nothing, yet falling for everything? Marching for nothing, yet falling for everything. You know, for starters, our Lord repeats and says, you know, constantly in the Holy Bible that we come in peace, guys. So, I mean, just based off that, would you say it's logical to be marching, protesting, or anything close to these things? You know what I mean? Once again, nobody has their own thoughts. So, I mean, I'm pretty sure people will be like, yeah, it's logical. You know, so people end up, you know, doing things that aren't logical because it's under the opponent's, it's under the accuser's agenda. It's under his agenda to do so. You know, instead of them telling you, go out here and, march, you know, and tell people anything about our Lord, you know, and like I said, you know, they're the ones that's telling everyone to go out here and do this. So, you know, they're not going to tell you to do anything in the way of our Lord. You know, as he taught us, as he said to do it, as he did already, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Because like I said, he is the one that is truly over you. He is the one that is truly ruling over you, reigning over you. Not this little fake government. So, you know, they're going to tell you everything that is in alignment with the accuser's, the opponent's agenda, instead of things being done in the way of our Lord. Like I said, as he told you to do it already. You know, but like I said, we lost our minds once we were not reading those words anymore. Once we had no way. I mean, the government's there to, I guess, you know, pick you up and put you in a line with them. Which is why you have to choose sides as well. And it's about that time. So, you know, these marches and protests and movements, you know, they aren't going to get us anywhere. Because we are already too far gone. Too far gone. The world is too far gone. The people and minds are too far gone. And most of all, the elite, the demons, are too far into their plans for any thing to change. The elite and the demons are too far into their plans for anything to change. You think you going out there protesting about one little thing in a whole sea of craziness that they have out here, you think that's going to make everything change? Once again, I ask, is it logical to really be protesting, to really be marching, to really be a part of these movements? I mean, people been having, like, literally people been having, like, Black Lives Matter for, like, the longest now. And I think black guys, black women, whatever, are still getting shot by cops, still getting shot by whatever, you know, whatever white person or whatever. I mean, they're still getting shot. I mean, I'm sorry, but Black Lives Matter, is a very pointless movement. And whatever else came after that, whatever matters. Well, whose ever lives matter? Like, you know, why is it not all lives matter? Why are we still, you know, fueling the oppression, in a sense? You know what I mean? Why are we still fueling the opponent's agenda? It's not Black Lives Matter. All lives matter. Like I said in my Hebrew Israelite camps podcast, guys, our Lord already established that the Jew and the Gentile, I mean, has, you know, it's about the inside now. So all lives matter, if anything, and all lives matter, meaning saving your soul, living eternally, all lives matter. So, you know, I think that's a very, very pointless movement, as well as all other whatever lives matter. I mean, it's all pointless because all lives matter, you know, and it's not going to change anything. Like I said, I mean, everything is too far gone for anything to change. The only thing you can change is yourself and your fate. That is why I stress so much, guys. That's why I stress so much to build, rebuild, do maintenance on your relationship with the Most High, with our Heavenly Father, with our Creator. The one that has the power to save or destroy your soul. That is why I stress so much to build, rebuild, or do maintenance on your relationship with the Most High, with our Heavenly Father. Do not get caught up and whatever schemes that the devil has out here. Because there's so many traps. And we're all falling for it. Like I said, we're standing for nothing and falling for everything. You know, like I said, this is the only way to make change. Guys, rebuilding, building, doing maintenance on your relationship with the Most High is the only way to make change. The only way to help and save others is by telling them this and telling them the truth. Telling them the truth. Helping them unplug. We've all been brainwashed. And we must unplug from this beast system. Not fuel it, not give it more energy. We need to unplug. Detach ourselves from this beast system. And we need to share that as well. We need to let people know. Don't go out there and be marching. That's why they have celebrities doing it. So, I mean, like they've been doing for years, guys, put a slap a celebrity on it and we'll buy it. We'll eat it up, right? That's why they're slapping celebrities on these marches, slapping celebrities on these movements, slapping celebrities on whatever. So you can eat it up, so you can be a part of it as well. Okay? Stop conforming. Stop doing what they tell you. Stop going in the opposite direction than our Lord. We've been doing it for too long. Pretty much everything the world says to indulge in is everything our Lord said not to indulge in. When they say go, our Lord's saying, you better stay right there. So they say go out there and protest about all